Now, let's discuss a special kind of memory-resident virus called Rootkit. A rootkit is embedded in an operating system. It typically modifies some of the code and even data structures of the operating system in order to perform some malicious activities. For example, a rootkit can be used to hide a malware from the user. For example, when the user uses the ls command to list the contents of a directory, the rootkit can change the output of the ls command so that the user will not see the malware file. Similarly, when the user uses the ps command to see what programs are running on the system, the rootkit can modify the output of the ps command to hide the running of the malware. Let's study an example of how rootkit can modify the operating system in order to perform malicious activities. For example, the rootkit is trying to hide the malware file from the user when he lists the contents of a directory. First, let's examine what happens when a user looks at the files in a directory. Suppose on Windows, the user used the command dir for looking at files in a directory. As we show here, this command can be implemented by a loop that keeps looking at the next file in the directory. Now, let's look at how a rootkit can hide a malware from the user when he looks at the files in a directory. We know that files and directories, they reside on hard drive, which is controlled by the operating system, meaning that any access to the hard drive has to go through the operating system. Therefore, in order to get information about files in a directory, we have to go through operating system functions in order to get such information. In other words, operating system functions are being called to look at information about files and directories on hard drive and return the results back to the user. So here is what an operating system will typically return when the user looks at files in a directory. That is, suppose the rootkit is not embedded in the OS yet. Then the OS will return all the files in the directory, including the malware file, say malco.exe. And this is the file that the rootkit will try to hide from the user. In order to hide the malware from the user, what the rootkit can do is to intercept any function call to the operating system, and then reason whether the call will end up revealing the malware. And if no, it will just pass the call to the appropriate operating system function. And if yes, it's going to execute the call, but intercept the result so that it can filter out the result as necessary in order to hide the malware. That is, the rootkit intercepts the function call to the operating system and knows that the operating system function call is looking at files in a directory, and then it knows that the return results may contain the malco.exe, so the rootkit will filter out the file name so that the user will not see this file name in the result. So here you go. When the rootkit is embedded in the operating system, it can filter out the malware file, so when a user looks at the files in a directory, he will not be able to see the malware. And this is how a rootkit in the OS can hide a malware from the user. Again, the rootkit is able to accomplish this by modifying the operating system. In particular, it intercepts function call to the operating system and filters the results of the function calls.